I'm Rachel and I'm a print artist, although if I'm honest, I don't really think of myself as an artist, because I think of an artist as someone who paints pictures, maybe makes prints, but that's not what I do. So I'm not really an artist in the conventional sense of the word. My practice is running printmaking workshops, and I think it's because I get such a buzz out of sharing knowledge and seeing people come into my studio who've never tried printmaking at all in their life, and suddenly they're walking away with a massive smile on their face and something that they've printed. And the great thing is they can then take that home, and I always give tips and little hints as to how they can carry on printmaking at home. When I was little, I always wanted to be an artist. But lots of people, teachers, even family said to me, well, if you want to be an artist, you've got to be really, really good. And if I'm honest, I always thought, well, why can't I be that person? But I probably listened too much to them. I did some art at school, but then when I left school, I ended up being an accountant all by mistake. I was there for about 10 years, and then after 10 years, I just woke up one day and thought, I cannot do this for the rest of my life. So I took a few courses in fine art, just at the adult education centre, and I also took a course in printmaking, and it was printmaking that really stuck with me, that just really ignited something in me that I just wanted to carry on doing and to pass on to other people. So I started doing it just with friends, children, and also with my nieces and my nephews. I did summer holiday sort of workshops at my mum and dad's house, and then lots of mums and dads said to me, well, we'd really, really like to have a go at doing this. Can you teach us? And that's really how I've ended up running workshops for adults. I sometimes go into schools and run big printing events at schools, but it's mainly teaching adults that I do now. The first printmaking technique I learned was screen printing. And after that, I was pretty much hooked on any single printmaking process that came my way. So screen printing is probably my first love. Then I went on to lino cut, and then I found out about all these different printmaking techniques that you can do using nature. So you've got cyanotypes, which uses two chemicals that react with the sun's rays. You've got haposomy, which uses the pigments in flowers where you smash them with a hammer, which is great fun. You've also got anthotypes, which use the pigments in flowers to, again, similar to cyanotype, it uses the sun's rays to react. Also jelly printing, where I've used different natural elements like leaves, petals, feathers to create prints. When you think of an artist's day-to-day life in a studio, you might think of them painting, sketching, drawing. Well, my practice is slightly different to that. My days are often spent sorting out workshops, so that might be putting them onto my website. Also, I have to market those workshops, sending out newsletter emails, doing social media. So there's quite a lot of admin involved. There's also the setting up of workshops, ordering materials. But also I have to make samples for the workshops. That might be because I need to photograph them to show people what they can achieve from the workshops. Or it might be sending samples to various venues, letting them know what people are going to be able to print when they do a workshop. What continues to drive me and motivates my practice is when I get feedback from people who have been on my workshops to say how they've absolutely loved learning a new skill, or how printmaking has opened up a new form of creativity to them, how it's inspired them, or even just how it's made them a more confident person. It's such a buzz passing on that knowledge and getting that response from people. I get bored quite easily, so I would say that my practice is definitely led by me looking what's going to be the next thing. Once I've done a workshop with a particular theme, I like to change it up a bit, or I might change it completely. I'm also led by the environment from season to season. Some of the workshops that I do are best depending on the time of the year. So it's definitely the environment that influences my workshops and my practice. The biggest change to my practice in recent times has definitely been lockdown. Before lockdown, I was doing workshops for my studio, I was going out to schools, I was going out to various venues and putting on workshops. That all stopped in lockdown. And so I had the challenge of taking my practice online. I must admit, the first few months, I didn't do any printmaking at all. It was very much head in the sand kind of thing. What I did do was spend about 3 months on my allotment, and that got me just closer to nature. I was with nature every single day, and I started to realise that I could use a lot of what was around me, a lot of what I was growing, that I could use for printmaking itself. And that's what's led me to the cyanotypes, the anthotypes, and the hathazomi. But I realised that just being on my allotment, mucking around with various natural elements wasn't going to make me any money. So I had to take my practice online. At the bottom of my to-do list has always been make video tutorials, but I've never ever had the time or the space to be able to do that. With lockdown, I was able to take a lot of my workshops online, plus do lots of video tutorials. I got involved in Medway Print Festival, which, because of lockdown, went online in 2020. And that just really set in motion just lots of different things that I could do video-wise. So Facebook Live, Instagram Live, video tutorials, and putting workshops online, sending people starter kits, also getting people to use what they had around their home for printmaking. Because let's face it, printmaking is such a basic form of art. Running printmaking workshops keeps me really busy, so I don't have an awful lot of time to practice my own printmaking. But when I do, I always lean towards the digital or the graphic look. And that's definitely something that screen printing is really good for. What I enjoy when I go to an art exhibition, for example, though, is the abstracts, and that's something that I'm trying to bring more into my practice. And I've been influenced by a local artist called Sheila Dyson, who does some amazing experiments. You never know what she's going to do from one day to the next. There's also an artist, Seth Apter, who layers texture and colour with monotypes and jelly prints that I really, really like at the moment. So I'm being influenced more by the abstract and the experimental. Enough about me, let's get down to some printing. So the technique that I'm going to show you is called screen printing. It's a resist printmaking technique, and it's called screen printing. This is the screen. It's made up of a frame with some nylon mesh pulled really, really tightly over it, so it kind of makes like a drum sound. The resist, or what stops the ink from getting through and onto your fabric, in this instance, is this brown blocking fluid. So the stencil is drawn onto the screen, it's then painted over with what's called drawing fluid, and then a squeegee is pulled with this brown blocking fluid. And then this is how you do the print. So I've got some fabric paint here. I've also laid out some fabric on the table. And I'm just spooning the fabric paint onto the screen, above where the open bit of the screen is. And then I use the squeegee to push the ink through the mesh and through onto the fabric. It makes such a satisfying noise. Just gonna go once more. Holding the fabric down, lifting the screen, I reveal the print. And that never gets boring. I see the future of I Printed That as being a mix of the old and the new. I'm still going to be doing in real life workshops, because nothing beats that one-to-one interaction with people. But I'll also be continuing with the online workshops, because that's meant that I've been able to print with people all around the world. The potential for that is absolutely amazing. Plus it means that I don't have to set up or clear up after anyone when a workshop's finished. In terms of content, I'm going to be running a lot more themed workshops. So talking about artists and their work and using their pieces as inspiration for the prints. Whilst creativity is such a drive for any artist practice, we can't ignore the fact that there are practicalities involved, such as earning a living. What drives my sales is my website and also my social media. My website is iprintedthat.com, where there's a list of all the current workshops. There's also a blog and printmaking tutorials. And my handle on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter is iprintedthat.